Amen.
Hallelujah. Song says there is more that I require. There's more that Jesus, there's more that God is requiring of us. And that's why I believe he wants to talk to us. He's trying to say something to us in these times right now. Hallelujah. But see, our minds and things of that nature, we're caught up on the wrong thing. We're hearing the wrong thing. We're paying so much attention to the news than we are God. Hallelujah. And don't get me wrong, pay attention. You know, stay up to date. Hallelujah. But make sure you're up to date on to the things that God wants you to be doing as well.
Amen.
Up to date on his word. Up to date on hearing his voice. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. When's the last time you heard him? Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Or have you been hearing everything else over him? Hallelujah. God is calling us, calling you, those who are, that are watching, calling us higher, if you will. But we are down in this low state, hallelujah, this low state of mind. And we it's like we're down and out for the count.
Mm-mm.
And won't get up.
Uh-oh.
And notice I said won't get up. Okay. It's not that you can't get up. It's like I'm not getting up no more because I'm tired of falling down. But you're going to fall. Yeah. You're going to go down.
Mm-hmm.
Probably because you haven't reached or met the requirements yet to stay up.
Uh-oh.
Hallelujah. He's calling you higher. There's more that he wants. Hallelujah. We're going to get ready to read Psalms. It's hard to see this on here, but Psalms 91.
Yeah.
1 through 2.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you right now for the message that's about to come forth. Lord, we just give you all the praise, glory, and honor. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for immediately already removing me out of the way and you taking over this thing right now in the name of Jesus, and you having your way and you doing what you see fit to be done right now. Touch the hearts and minds of the people right now. Let their ears be open so they can hear, not just hear me, Lord, but hear you through me right now in the name of Jesus. Do what only you can do right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Stretch across right now the internet, Lord. Set the atmosphere right now in the name of Jesus. Stretch across our cities, our state, our the United States, hallelujah, our world. Hallelujah. Touch those right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
It says, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Hallelujah. When I look at this, hallelujah. And when you look at this, I don't know if you recognize it, but I recognize a promise.
Okay.
Hallelujah. I recognize a promise that is within there. One of the things that I recognize, hallelujah, when you dwell in the shadow of the Almighty, first, you will be hidden. It's a promise. Hallelujah. Second, hallelujah, you will be covered. Third, provided for completely. Those are the promises, or the promise that's hidden, if you will, within this scripture. Which leads me to the title of today's word, hallelujah. Are you covered?
Okay.
See, God this morning, he set me down, he did a whole change up on me. I had something totally different. The sermon was ready to go. It was set out. Had everything planned out. All the slides ready. And he's like, oh no. I mean, God will do that to you sometimes.
Amen.
Especially when we're doing it out of our own will or out of our own selves.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if I was just doing it out of my own will. I just felt that in my spirit. somewhere. But God, he will redirect and change some things. It's not that it ain't in the spirit. It's just not time for that to come out. But he gave me, are you covered? When you look at your life today, do you believe you're covered? Hallelujah.
Come on.
Do you believe you are covered? Not even do you believe, do you know that you are covered? Hallelujah. There's something about being covered. Hallelujah. When you are covered, hallelujah, you are hidden.
Yes.
It's hard to get to you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I mean, it's like ain't nothing touch you. Well, it can try to, but it doesn't affect you. It's the same thing as getting insurance coverage on your car.
Okay.
Or your home. Even though something comes in and touches it and tries to destroy it or does, you're covered so it is replaced. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. The coverage helps you keep what was given. Mm. The coverage helps you keep what is already yours.
Okay.
The coverage helps you not even feel the damage that took place. If you will. Most of you guys out there don't even have car insurance, so don't tell me you're covered. I'm just, you know. But think about it.
We used to do that.
You know, yeah, we did. We used to roll around and didn't have no car insurance. Just roll. Thank God that he covered us.
Amen.
Because that's the true covering. Thank God that he covered us so much so that we didn't get jacked up and messed up. But don't play with God.
Through our disobedience.
Don't play with him. Hallelujah. If you will, don't play with his grace.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But think about your life. Are you covered? Are you doing what Psalms 91, 1 and 2 is talking about? Are you dwelling in the shadow of the Most High? Hallelujah. Are you up under his wing, if you will? Hallelujah. Are you in the midst of getting ready to receive the promises which comes with dwelling in the shadow of the Almighty? Are you well taken care of? Do you know who your provider is?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Or are you considering Walmart and Myers your provider?
Uh-oh.
Or are you considering Dollar General and all these other stores that we've been running to and going crazy over in the last week or so are providers?
Uh-oh.
Your job, is that your provider? Because some of us ain't there right now.
Uh-oh.
Is that your provider? When things go on in the world like it is right now with this virus trying to take over the world, where can you get provided for? Who is your provider?
Okay.
Who can you trust? Who can you lean on? Hallelujah. Because sooner or later, you just may be locked inside and can't go get toilet paper.
Uh-oh.
Sooner or later, you may be locked inside and can't go get sanitizer or Lysol or water.
Uh-uh.
Who is your provider? Hallelujah. Are you covered by him? Jesus. God. Are you hidden in him?
Uh-huh.
Again, you ever play hide and go seek? And then the seeker comes out to find you. If you're covered real well, they can't find you. I remember playing a lot of times and I did things that I didn't want to do. Like get inside of thorn bushes. Wasn't nobody coming in there. They wasn't. And all I had to do when I stepped in and kind of ducked into there was not make a sound, even though sometimes it hurt.
Okay.
And I say that because just because you're covered by God don't mean you won't feel a little something.
Okay.
You know that the Satan to come along and yeah, you're covered, he can't see you, but he might poke.
Uh-oh.
Don't make a sound. Trust God. Trust in the Almighty.
Uh-oh.
See, I was in that thing, in that bush. Ooh, cover. As soon as I would have been like, ooh. They'd have got me, or tried to, or they would have reached their own sticky and like, tag, you're it. And then I'd have been like, well, you didn't touch me. Well, I'm touching the stick, and the stick touched you, you're it. Think about this thing. Are you covered? Are you truly saved by the grace, saved by grace through faith, or is that just something you just continue to say?
think about that. We continue. We do say that a lot. Man, I'm saved by grace through faith. And move on. Like it's nothing. What is grace? Do you really have faith? Do you really have the faith? Hallelujah. Do you really know what grace is, or are you playing with grace? Are you playing with that thing? Are you playing, hallelujah, are you playing with your covering? Yeah. Hallelujah. Because when God covers me, hallelujah, I know who I'm covered by. I know who I belong to. And I don't want to play with that thing. I don't want to put God to the test, if you will. See, God is saying something to his people this morning, hallelujah, concerning this coronavirus. He wants to know, are you covered? And if you're not, you better get some coverage. My wife mentioned earlier, every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that he is Lord, even the coronavirus.
Amen.
Every name will forget their name and know his name. Hallelujah. Their name carries no power unless you give it to them. And when I look back, as I keep on looking, we've been given a lot of power to the coronavirus. Stop calling its name. Call on Jesus. Stop worrying about it. And I know it's hard. I know it's hard. But stop worrying about it. Stop focusing on it. The more you put your focus on it, the more you have a concern for it. If you focus on God, your concern will be with God. Are you covered? Are you truly saved by grace through faith? Faith. When I think about grace, for me, grace equals Jesus. Faith equals believing in grace, which brings us back to Jesus. Can you say Jesus with me?
Jesus.
Grace equals Jesus. Faith equals believing in grace, which is
Jesus.
Hallelujah. She's my help to this morning. Hallelujah. So if you know grace to be Jesus and you have faith and you believe in grace, then you believe in Jesus. Hallelujah. It's something about the name of Jesus. You know, I know the song, it says it's something about the name of Jesus. It is the sweetest name I know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I don't know who this is for right now, but God is saying to his people, everything, hallelujah, everything that was so-called taken or snatched away, if you will, don't be surprised if it shows back up at the doorstep.
Amen.
Don't be surprised if it shows back up knocking. Hallelujah. Don't be surprised. Don't think of it as a coincidence. Oh, now you're showing back up. Coronavirus must be getting to you. No, it's not that. Hallelujah. God said, don't be surprised. And this time, if things start showing back up with things, people, whatever it is, be prepared. It's coming. It's going to knock. But you got to be able to give the same grace.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You got to be able to give the same grace. You got to be able to introduce them to the covering.
Amen.
Just like you've been covered. Because see, they're going to see something, or it's going to know something that you know, like, well, how are you sustaining? How are you surviving in this time? I need what you got. So don't be surprised if it knocks back at your door. Hallelujah. I won't be before you long. Hallelujah. But I do want to ask again, are you covered? Hallelujah. Can we go to Exodus? Right here it says in Exodus 12 and 13. It says, and the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where ye are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you.
And the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land. I had a lot of people ask me, even on my job, you know, or throughout my job, not just certain people that I just work with, you know, right in the building that I'm in, but just when I'm on the outside or in the other buildings or whatever, why do you think God would do this? First of all, I just want to say that God didn't do anything. God didn't bring on the coronavirus. God didn't bring on the flu. God didn't bring on any of the troubles. God is not a God that he would do that. But Satan is so evil that he would scheme up a plan to try to destroy the people. Hallelujah, if you will. He will scheme up a plan. But see, his plan can't go into effect unless he asks God. Hallelujah. Take that down. His plan can't go into effect unless he asks God. See, just because he roams the land seeking whom he may devour don't mean he gets to devour anybody. He needs permission. Hallelujah. He needs the permission to even test you, to try it. But God will say, okay, yes, I've talked about this many of times concerning Job. God will say, yes, you can. I'll open the door for you so you can go in and try it. But I'm telling you, they won't fall for your schemes or your tricks. Hallelujah. If you're falling for the schemes and tricks, you need to get up and get yourself covered. Hallelujah. You need to get up, hallelujah, and run back to God, hallelujah. See, God is seeing some people that have strayed away, and I think he's using this thing. No, I don't think. I believe he's using this thing to reel you back in, hallelujah. Stop trying to take the line out farther and just let him reel you in. Uh-oh. Hallelujah. Let him have it. Give him yourself. Give yourself away to God and stop giving yourself away to the tricks and schemes of Satan and the problems of this world.
Okay.
Hallelujah. Satan comes up with the plan. God looks over the plan and he can go, okay, you think this stupid little plan is really going to get my people. Go ahead. Try it. And lo, what do we see? People fighting over toilet paper. People fighting and beating each other up over water and hand sanitizer and all kinds of things. We see crazy things going on, but all the people are forgetting about God. Satan has you right where he wants you. Hallelujah. If the coronavirus don't get you, you're going to get each other. Come on now. Don't forget about your covering. Hallelujah. I don't care how much toilet paper you get. You ain't covered. I don't care how much sanitizer you pick up. That ain't going to help cover you. Hallelujah. Right here it says, and the blood shall be to you for a token upon the house where you are. It's something about the blood of Jesus. Are you covered by the blood of the Lamb this morning? Hallelujah. You can throw so much toilet paper over the house that you won't, because I know some of us out there got enough. Go on and toilet paper your house. That ain't going to cover you. Go on and sanitize the walls outside. That ain't going to cover you. It's the blood. It's Jesus. Okay. Jesus is the covering. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Satan got all of us out here in a circle, and this is what he's doing. This is what he's doing. He's going around the circle, hallelujah, going duck, 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 duck. See, he know the duck. He can't get them ducks, hallelujah. Duck, duck, duck. Oh, you silly goose. Gotcha. The one that just isn't covered. Hallelujah. See, my doorpost. Hallelujah. My heart. Hallelujah. My mind. My home. My family is covered. Hallelujah. Ain't no corona getting in here. Hallelujah. Because there's something about the name. Hallelujah. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Hallelujah. That's who we're caught up on.
Amen.
That's who we're covered by. So when it comes past, it's, man, I can't go in there.
Amen.
Even if I can try to get a foot in, they're going to blow me away. It's something in there. It's something in there that I can't handle. Hallelujah. Just as God allowed Satan to go through with his plan, he could shut it down. He can shut it down.
Okay.
Where is your faith this morning?
Amen.
What do you believe in this morning?
Okay.
You had faith 2 weeks ago and all of a sudden you lost it?
Uh-oh.
Where is it? You can't have faith when things are right. You got to have faith when it goes left as well. Come on. Where is your faith this morning? Hallelujah. But you steady yelling out, I'm saved by grace through faith. You lost some faith. Hallelujah. Are you covered? Hallelujah. Whose blood? Now, there it is. Whose blood you got on your doorpost? Whose blood you got on your hands or on your heart or on your mind? Whose blood covers you this morning? Who do you pray to?
Okay.
As the last song said, who do you say yes to? God is calling us higher. God is saying in these times, there is more that I require of thee. First of all, come on unto me. First of all, come on in. First of all, sign on up for the coverage. Hallelujah. He is everything we need.
Yes, Lord.
He is more than enough. My God will supply all my needs.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Your God, hallelujah. If you're serving Jesus, hallelujah. If you're serving the God Almighty, if you're serving the God we know, all your needs shall be supplied. Again, you will be hidden, you will be covered, and you will be provided for completely.
Yes.
Look around. Are you dwelling under the wrong shadow? Come on. Hallelujah. Get covered. And that's all that God gave me this morning. Hallelujah. Did you pray as I?
I got three practical things. I got to thank you. Amen. That was a good word. While I was sitting back there, I got three practical ways to look at this in our life. And the first thing that God spoke to me back there was, check your coverage protection. What does it say for your situation? He gave me 2 Timothy 2:15. Be diligent to present yourself approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So as he was talking about insurance coverage, I thought, well, wow, Lord, a lot of us don't even know what it says in our insurance policies, just like a lot of us don't know what the Word of God says in our lives when it comes to something pertaining to our lives. So he said, do you even know what it says? Amen. So the first thing to do is just see what it says. Hallelujah. Read your Bible. Amen. When you read your Bible, he will show you what your coverage says. As he gave the word so beautifully a minute ago. And then the second point was, our needs and things change in our life a lot of times. So make sure you keep up with your coverage. Read your Bible again and study. Renew your mind. Romans 12:2 says, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. So renew your mind. Things will change in your life. Circumstances will change in your life. Know what the word of God is saying by renewing your mind daily. because things will change just like coverages change. Things change in your policy. Amen. But the word of God doesn't change. It's just things in our life changes. Amen. And we need to continue to see what the word of God says. And number three, pull out your coverage protection and remind the policyholder of what it says. Hallelujah. Proverbs 18:21 says, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. So I know there's a lot of things that we want to say to God. I know there's a lot of complaining that we want to do whenever things aren't going our way or whenever bad circumstances are happening. But we have life and death in our tongue. So we need to pull that out and say, God, your word says this. And begin to declare that word so that life can continue to take place as he said earlier. Amen. So that was a beautiful word. And that's something that God gave to me back there. And it's just three practical keys for life. Read your Bible. Study your Bible. As things change, renew your mind. See what the word of God is saying to you as things in life change. And then speak life and death. Declare it out of your mouth. Because life and death are in the power of our tongue. And we shall eat whatever we say. Amen. I'm going to go ahead and pray us out. And thank you, honey, for that word. Father God, we thank you for your word today, Lord. We thank you for everybody who joined in today. We thank you that it will be sown on good ground, Father God. We thank you that it will come forth and as fruit in people's lives, 30, 60, and 100-fold, Father, in the name of Jesus. I pray that as we all go and do what we have to do today, Lord God, that you will protect us. Keep us safe and healthy, Lord God. And as we all continue to check on one another, I pray that we will find out what each other needs and help one another. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.